Sandland, the land of sand. Good evening. As you can see, it's a sort of a festive occasion tonight. It's more of a, it's not festive really, it's a different mood review of a different mood fragrance. I wouldn't even call it fragrance. I will dig into there a little bit later on what I think there. But today is definitely a special review on a special fragrance or a special scent or special feeling, if you will. As you can see, it's already here behind me in this white little bag, and there's a little story to it. Good friends of the family have recently traveled to Firenze, to Florence in Italy, and in Firenze, in Florence, there is a nose, a parfumier, one of the most famous ones of Italy, called Lorenzo Villoresi, who runs his own house. It's a niche house. He has several quite well-known fragrances. They're quite, high-level, high-quality stuff. Things like Piper Negro, for example, or Musk, I think, that has been worn or still being worn by Brad Pitt. And even Uomo as well, I think, and Sandara and all these Lorenzo Villoresi fragrances are being considered as special, very natural, niche fragrances from Lorenzo Villoresi. They have an Italian vibe about them as well. And so, when I got to know that my friends are going down to Florence, I told them, I've been to Florence once, 1991, but I have never been to Lorenzo Villoresi, and there is a scent of Lorenzo Villoresi that I would like to have, because I had a little vial sample there before, and I was totally blown away by the scent, and I asked them if they could, bring it, and they actually visited. I gave them the address and what I wanted to have, and so they visited the street and the address basically. They thought they found nothing, because it's just a regular street in Toscana, in Firenze, with a regular house with some doorbells on. So they went to the nearest shop and asked, we are looking for Lorenzo Villoresi. And they told them, yes, just there, you just got a ring. So they rang, and they could, got into a flat with a very special atmosphere, basically like a fragrance laboratory with all little vials and but sales stuff as well, and different rooms, where people, visitors are being escorted to try fragrances, to buy fragrances. And actually the maestro Villoresi was there as well. And they bought the fragrance that I asked them to buy, and they just got the fragrance. They bought it last Thursday, if I remember well. Today is Monday, so they arrived back and gave this to me. So I'm gonna unbox it now. It's here, still in the original. There's nothing visible though. Yes, it is Lorenzo Villoresi Firenze, and the fragrance itself is. Let's see if it's visible or not really. I'm not sure if you can see it or not. Anyway, it is because it has this, now probably. It's Lorenzo Villoresi Firenze Vintage Collection Incensi Eau de Toilette. It's a 100 ml. And what's interesting is that with this they had you know, there's this Lorenzo Villoresi head paper, like a tri strip, you know, piece of paper. And they got it on Thursday and still on there, the fragrance is still on there. You can smell clearly the dry down of the fragrance here. So much about longevity of the fragrance, no? Brilliant. But I'm gonna unbox it here now in front of you. I'm not very good in this. I'm quite impatient usually. I'm trying my best now to get this open. But I can already sense that I'm gonna be impatient again, you know. It's actually interesting because it's not your usual thing. It's wrapped in this stuff. And Lorenzo. Incensi. It's from the vintage collection. You have to know that there are some of his fragrances have been not discontinued, but they're not available anymore. And for example, the shop that carries Villoresi here in my city. So, but they have issued anyway something called a vintage collection where the classic Villoresi fragrances are being listed in, and this is in there. So it's still alive, still in production. And so basically this is a sort of a new release of Incensi. As the name says, it's an incense fragrance. And it came out in 1997. Just looking if I have anything on, but nothing really on this one. So I'm gonna give it a very generous sprayer. It's the first time I see a bottle like this. It's very classy, very nice. The bottom it says Lorenzo Villoresi Firenze. On the top it says that as well. Fairly simple. But very tasteful done. The sprayer cap, very nice. It's very classy, I think. So, Ellen Willia. This is something that is really something that is not a fragrance to me. And, you know, first and foremost, it's a very special feeling. It's a mood. It's something that is very difficult to, not for me, not to get emotionally or emotional in the review, because I could start with listing the notes, you know, that incense is there, and there is cinnamon in there, and but you know, green notes, and it's a bit bitter as well. Is it churchy? Is it not churchy? I don't know. It may be a little bit churchy, yes, if you want, though. I've smelled loads of incense fragrances. I mean, from the Montales, from, you know, Full Incense even, or Comme des Garçons, Avignon, and Healy's Cardinal, you know, I've been through them. You know, each of them is nice, or each of them are nice. But this is something different to me. This is, I said, to me, it's not a fragrance. It's, and this sentence, this vision was inside of my head for so long. It's a, to me, Lorenzo Incensi is a breath of eternal life. This is something that evokes memories in me of people who are, you know, not here anymore with us. It evokes a mood and brings some thoughts to me about our own lives, about the meaning of life, about, you know, what matters in life and what doesn't. And it is just I don't want to, you know, sound like melancholic and it's, you know, it's not that it's depressing or anything, like it just for some reason it touches me somehow in a way that I haven't really felt from a fragrance before. It is just out of this world, in my opinion. It's like that. I've been in a, if you know, I could probably, the picture it I get from it in my mind is I've been to Ireland, to a place called Tourmachidi in County Mayo, where once the great actor Robert Shaw lived for in the later years of his life, and there is a ruin of a church, a cathedral church, is small, of an old Catholic church in there. You know, it doesn't have any roof anymore, it doesn't have windows, but you can go inside and the walls are still there and everything is there, but just the windows and the roof is missing, and beside it it's a graveyard there. And to me, this is the feeling, you know, again, nothing negative about it, it's uplifting. I don't know if you have ever felt that when you walk in a cemetery, actually, that somehow you get a, you know, this feeling the feeling overwhelms you of the thought of life after death and an eternal being in some shape or form, you know, and the breath of eternal life. This is what this brings to me. And in this church in Ireland, in Tourmachidi, this came to me, you know, this reminds me of that somehow, that it's a ruin, and to be the graveyard attached, yet it has such an energy, such a presence, and it is really heavenly. It's heavenly, and this scent combines to me all that. So this is why today's review is a bit special, with the candle and, you know, this setting, back to this setting again, where I started from. Some thoughts on when to wear it. Whenever you feel like you need a time off, you know, just time off, you know, like, or you need to gather your inner thoughts, your senses, your being on earth, when you want to focus on what matters, get this on, this will help. It's almost like treatment, really. But again, it's never negative, it's a positive, great thing, you know. So even if you're talking about cemetery or people who have, you know, died and are not with us anymore, it's nothing negative. It's part of life, and it's just glorious and really heavenly and uplifting to think that there's an eternal life, and this fragrance breeds that. So anybody who would like to sort of try this experience, do it. Same goes for age group. I would not like to analyze this time. As I said, silage and projection are moderate, nothing beastly, so you won't blow people away with this. Just handle it carefully. And as I said, with this little paper there that Lorenzo Villoresi shop gave with together with the fragrance is still on there, so it lasts for days. Projection, longevity is brilliant. To me, this scent is definitely for you first, for the wearer first, and then for anyone else around you to enjoy. I would mainly wear this fragrance for, you know, for me and for what it is. It's definitely not a work scent or you know, clubbing scent or no. This is something for you to enjoy and feel your utmost inner being. You know, the get the full meaning of life. Today I would like to finish with a sentence that came today to my mind, because again, as it happens in life, we heard about the passing of a friend, good friend. And a sentence came to my mind as I was sitting in the office, actually, that how did it go? Love is the only thing that prevails in life. Whether you have it or you're missing it, one thing is sure: you're nothing without it. And this is something that I feel very true, not because I sort of had the idea of this thought, but it's you know, it's what my heart tells me. And I would like to finish with that thought today's review. I'll be back. It was a pleasure. Thank you very much for sharing tonight's review with me. And see you very soon again. Bye bye and good night.